This is just a test of the emergency broadcast system. Hey, it's your girl Tipsy with Fee coming at you with a single mom pro tip. And today we're going to talk about communication. How do we communicate in the most toughest of situations with the other co-parent? And I took some notes. Communication can either strengthen or weaken your co-parenting situation. Here are some tips that I personally utilized in my journey to become a better co-parent, to become a better parent, period. Let's talk about communication in the initial breakup. It's shitty. It's non-existent. It's filled with breakup rage. The best advice that I can give for that stage of your communication journey is you gotta heal. And you can't place your healing on what the other parent is doing. You gotta do your own healing and you gotta get some resolve. Whatever your relationship problems were cannot be your parenting problems. You have to differentiate, especially if your breakup has nothing to do with the child. If you are breaking up because of the child, do you, boo-boo. Have no advice for that. But for all of those of us that are just breaking up because we can't stand the other co-parent or whatever the situation may be at the time, you want to make sure that you heal. And here's the pro tip. You got to give grace to the other co-parents and let them heal. Just because you're in a place of healing, that you're in a place of growth, does not mean that that other parent is in that place. And I had to learn that the hard way. I was on my road to healing and my co-parenting partner was not. And it took my therapist to let me know that everybody is not going to heal at the same time. Not everybody's going to get over things at the same time. I can only control me. Message! People get over hurt and pain at different rates. They do it differently, different methods. You have to give your co-parenting partner some sort of modicum of grace and time. Do the work on you, and that's all you can control, and that's what you should control, is your behavior and you. If you're still in the early stages of breaking up, you just broke up, you just moved out, you've been moved out, and the communication is hard. Again, I'm going to reiterate that last one. Do your own personal healing. Get to a place where you're not holding on to anger. Don't hold on to anger is the next pro tip. Let that shit go. If you broke up and you're mad, you got to learn to not be mad, because that is an area of opportunity for you to constantly be picked with. If your co-parenting partner knows that they have a way to irritate you, they probably will exploit that. So do your good healing, and anything that you're pissed off about, you're gonna have to learn how to get over it. Get over your anger. I think that's part of healing. The next pro-parenting tip is do not speak when you're upset. Once you realize you are entering argument land, argument land is a weird fucking place. Once you realize you're there, cut it off. Just say, hey, we're not gonna get anywhere on this topic today because you're angry, I'm angry. How about we revisit this at a time where cooler heads can prevail? Sometimes that might take you hanging up on somebody when they are just persistent that they want to talk about it today. Sometimes you gotta show them. And that takes practice, because I found myself getting caught up in unnecessary arguments just because I was in moment not saying to myself, stop the argument. We're not doing the yelling and the arguing and screaming because my feelings aren't wrapped up in you anymore. So what's the arguing about? Keep it business. Keep it professional. If you're angry, try again another day. Which leads into a great segue into keep it professional. If we're talking about the kid and we're talking about business, like, when are you picking them up? Here's what happened at school. The kid wants to talk to you, or whatever it is you guys are talking about, it keep it professional, keep it business, especially in those days where the communication can be a little strained. If you keep it about business and keep the emotion out of it, your conversations are going to go a lot smoother. And it's up to you to be that beacon of stability and light, to exhibit the qualities that you want your co-parenting partner to exhibit. Calm, resolve, you know, you're keeping things professional. You're not bringing in past situations or emotions into the situation. The next parenting pro tip: when they go low, you go high. If someone's being disrespectful, you make it your point to be the most respectful. You need to display the character traits that you want your partner, your co-parenting partner, to display. You want them to talk to you with respect, you have to talk to respect. If you want them to talk calm and with some resolve, you have to do that. You have to set the playing field and the basis for how you want the communication to go. And you have to let them know if they're being disrespectful. Hey, I'm not calling you on your name. I'm not being disrespectful. And let that be the pattern, because eventually they're going to wake up like, oh my God, I look like a fucking asshole because I'm sitting here yelling and screaming at a person that is only being respectful to me. Set the example. I know it sucks for a lot of a single parent to have to be, to step up and be that one. But sometimes one of you got to, you know, you got a goal in mind. Do not cut your nose off to spite your face. You know what I mean? Keep it cool, keep it calm, keep it classy. Ooh! Keep it calm, keep it cool, keep it classy. The three C's, baby. Three C on their ass. Keep it calm, keep it cool, keep it classy. I should have just ended the video with that. I should have started and ended with, when you communicate as a single parent, keep it cool, keep it calm, keep it classy. And if the conversation gets disrespectful, there is a block button, there is a hang up button, and then you can always go back and have that conversation when cooler head prevails. I am giving you guys this bit of knowledge and this bit of experience because I went through it. It took me going to therapy to realize that I was holding on to anger and resentment for my co-parenting partner, and I was never going to attain or reach the goals that I wanted to reach having a ill communication style with him. I'm a cool ass girl. And when you're going out of a relationship, that coolness can become hardened, can become jaded. But what I wanted to return to is the essence of who I am. I'm a cool ass broad, and you can't rattle my cage unless I let you. You can't disrespect me and me feel bad about myself. I'm not going to let you do that. I'm not going to let you have that power over me. I'm not going to let you talk disrespectfully to me. Nor am I going to speak disrespectfully about you or to you. You know, because at the end of the day, we're a team. And I would like my teams to be well-maintained, well-oiled, and well-functioning. And again, all this stuff, like I said, I think our journey to establish a good communication style, it took years. I'm not even gonna front. We are at a great space now where we can talk. We've come out of the, I gotta keep this cool, calm, classy. We ain't talk about no shit else. All we talking about is the kid. Where now we actually can have conversations about shit outside of our kid, and it's cool. And it's not a necessary conversation. We'll talk about that in another series, in another video on what's too much communication. This was just, how do we get to good communication in our parenting, single parenting journey? And it's your girl, Tipsy with Feet, coming at you with the I should coin this. Keep it cool, keep it calm, keep it classy. It's your girl, Tipsy with Feet, coming at you with another single mom pro tip. Peace. Oh, and by the way, I completely overdid it with this makeup. I was going to go for subtle. Baby, I went for a full face of glam and was not prepared, okay? Next video, I'm doing subtle browns and something a little bit more natural, because this, honey, is a full face.